I started with a imitation Les Paul. It was a black Tara, it was called, T-A-R-A, and my buddy was buying a new guitar, so he sold me it for 10 bucks.
Cool, cool.
So I had been drawn to the guitar for years before that. I asked my parents for a guitar for Christmas and just never arrived, so I took it upon myself to buy my first guitar, and then I just always loved it. Just I got right into songwriting as soon as I picked up the guitar. Taught myself really how to play, and been doing it ever since I was 11. Yeah, single cutaway. I like the weight of a Les Paul and single cuts. That's why when we did the PRS, needed it to be heavy, and the switching had to be. I had to be used to where the pickup selector was. You know, a lot of the initial PRSs had the switching down below. So me being picky and liking the guitars that way got me a signature model. Not right from the beginning. I think it took a couple years, and then we put out the SE and it took off and it became the biggest seller. So it was, now we have two versions of the SE. So, you know, it's doing well. We dig it. I need to have both. You know, I like, when I'm playing at home, I like to have a fixed bridge because I'm tuning all over the place. But when I'm performing, sometimes I like to have the bar just for, you know, dive bomb shenanigans or, you know, whatever I'm doing. You know, but it's good to have both. You can't. I don't like to use a lot of low tunings with the bar on there because it's just tuning wise, it works better to have that fixed bridge. Yeah, I have a 7-string. It's a song that we play in the set, Show Me a Leader, that's on a 7-string guitar, but it's the only song I've ever done on the 7-string. I still like 6-strings a hell of a lot more than 7s, but it's a good to experiment with. That's just a one-off, you know, or actually there's two of them, so it's a two-off, but it's, I just went up to the factory and me and Paul drew it on his board and they made it for me, you know, and it's the only PRS with an upside down headstock. It plays amazing. I love it. But we actually just released a baritone guitar. It's a baritone hybrid, which is not quite a baritone, bigger neck scale length than normal PRSs. And it's actually the same as like a Fender Strat scale length, 25.5-inch scale length. But it's you can tune the guitar down to C sharp standard and have it just play like a, you know, a little stiffer than a normal guitar in standard tuning. So you can play all those songs that are way down in big low tunings and still be able to solo because the G string doesn't have to be wound. So it's a perfect tool for people like me who have a deeper voice and I have to tune my songs down and still be able to solo in those low tunings. Mm-hmm. I think he's more and more open-minded as the years go by. You know, we just developed a guitar amplifier and I'm sure there's things he'd want to change about it, but that's not the style of his playing. So when he tells the guys, let's cut out some of this or cut out some of that, and I'm like, no, let's keep that because that's what makes it, you know, the amp I want to use. I think he just backs off and lets it happen, you know, because he's got his hands in everything at PRS. So he gets to have, you know, he's got an amp called Paul's amp. So Paul's amp sounds exactly like the way Paul wants it to sound. My amp will be exactly how I want it to sound. So if you listen to the new record, that's what I recorded it with. It's the prototype of my new amp, that track, the new album. But it's only a 15 watt amp. So it's I wanted them to create an entry level amp. I said it can't go over $700. It's versatile. I think it's an amazing little amp. If I had that amp when I was a kid, it would have been a dream come true. No, I mean, when I'm writing, it's just whatever's sitting around that has 6 strings on it. A lot of my guitars will have 4 strings on it because I've broken them and I'm just too lazy to get up and change the strings. So I'll go to the next case and grab a guitar that has 6 strings on it. Like I said, all these guitars, they play so well. One plays almost as well as the next one. So, but the problem is I don't have a lot of these at home. All these are on tour. So I've got maybe one or two at home. All the rest are like a McCarty or a David Grissom or a Strat or a Tele or an acoustic or whatever. So I write on everything. Not forget, let
let your memory go.
Somebody's always around watching, you know. So it's there's always eyes on all the gear. So you know, it hasn't happened. So it only happened back when things have gotten stolen twice. Once when we were on tour and we had our entire trailer stolen with all our gear in it. And then we had it stolen from a rehearsal pad where a kid had a key to the warehouse we were in and went in there and stole some stuff. But never from off stage, because there's too much security. So I'm a very simple, I use a wah pedal and an overdrive pedal, pretty much that's it. You know, I don't use a lot of, you know, I have a Univibe in my rig that I use maybe for a minute of the entire show. I have an octave pedal that I might use for a minute the entire show, but other than that, it's just direct into the amps. When I was young, it was speed metal guys, you know, the Metallica guys, the Slayer guys, the Testament guys, Anthrax, and then as far as guitar players went, I started buying guitar instructional DVDs from guys like Paul Gilbert and Vinnie Moore and of course, Yngwie. Everybody had an Yngwie instructional DVD. But now it's just changed to more of guys like, I like Derek Trucks a lot. I think he's amazing. I like Warren Haynes a lot. Joe Bonamassa, I think, as talented as they get. So I'm kind of more steered towards that style playing now. Yeah. I know I might just sacrifice some... I would say learn the blues first. You know, learn the rules. It's the opposite of how I learned. I didn't follow any rules. I didn't know what the scales were. I didn't know what anything was. I just wanted to see whatever my fingers could reach and sounded good, I played. And then little by little, it became clear. But if I was to start over again, I'd say I would like to start learning a simple, you know, dominant blues and a simple minor blues and learn what works over the key changes. Or the chord changes, and learn the basics before going and trying to learn an Yngwie solo, you know? Yeah.